The software you see here is written in Java. It is freely available at the link you see in the bottom right corner. The software runs directly in a browser. It can be used to explore the simplest magnetic resonance phenomenon. It is a simple simulator that can illustrate compass magnetic resonance, which have much in common with nuclear magnetic resonance. Initially you see a compass needle. We can introduce a magnetic field and the compass needle will adjust itself along the direction of the field. Like a pendulum, it will oscillate before it comes to rest, pointing along the direction of the field. Here, one full oscillation of the needle takes approximately 2 seconds. The oscillation frequency is therefore around half a hertz. The relaxation time is seen to be around 10 seconds. Let's adjust the magnetic field down by a factor of 2. I remove the needle and put it back in. We can now see that the oscillation happens significantly slower. In fact, the vibration frequency is proportional to the magnetic field. Let's adjust the field back up. I remove the needle and put it back in. Once again, we see the vibration of the magnetic dipole. As long as the needle vibrates, it generates an oscillating magnetic field that we can detect with a coil. This is the MR signal that here disappears on a timescale of 10 seconds. Our task now is to make the signal reappear without touching the needle. For this we need a second magnetic field perpendicular to the strong B0 field. We call this weak field for B1. The B1 field pushes one end of the needle and pulls the other. Since B1 is weak compared to B0, it just rotates the magnetic needle slightly. If we remove the B1 field, the needle resumes its direction along the B0 field. This vibration is too weak to generate a measurable signal. We need to make the needle oscillate more. This can be accomplished by repeatedly pushing the compass needle with the B1 field. We pursue this idea by making the B1 field oscillate. Our first attempt here does not seem successful. The needle does vibrate slightly, but not enough to give a measurable signal. We can improve the situation much if we adjust the frequency of the B1 field to the natural vibration frequency of the compass needle. Repeated weak pushes can have a large effect when applied in synchrony with the natural oscillation. This is the resonance condition. You use the same principle when you want to make a child in a swing move. When applied to magnetic resonance, the B1 field pushes the compass needle in synchrony with its natural oscillation. Only when the resonance condition is met, the weak B1 field has a large effect. When doing MR measurements, we interleave excitation periods with measurement periods. We therefore now turn off the B1 field. We measure the signal while it decays away due to relaxation. We subsequently reintroduce the B1 field to set the needle in strong motion again. This is called the pulse-acquire experiment, and it is typically repeated. We excite. And we measure. This concludes the demonstration of compass magnetic resonance. There are differences to nuclear magnetic resonance, but the underlying principles are the same. Atomic nuclei do not move quite like compass needles, since they precess rather than just vibrate in a plane. The difference is subtle and the consequences limited. If nuclei behaved exactly like compass needles, it would still be possible to do magnetic resonance imaging, even using the exact same equipment as is being used today. The software you have seen here is freely available on the internet. It is useful, for example, to give students a first idea of the magnetic resonance phenomenon.